hunt for the largest salamander in North America. Today we are looking for the Hellbender. All right, everybody, and welcome back to Jack's World of Wildlife. Now, myself and my cameraman have just endured about 28 hours in the car.
Ow! I don't like being in the car this long. We're going a little crazy, man.
This was a really good idea.
GA, you're one big beaver.
And probably around the ballpark of 36 hours awake.
Tell your viewers what you just told me.
I said I need to hold my skin on. The weight is too much for me to bear. We're just moving right along in the middle of nowhere, Pennsylvania.
What are we at, 30 hours now? Something like that?
I've lost track. I've lost track, honestly, Gabe. And we're supposed to be filming like this? We're like animals. I slaughtered them like animals. I hate them. Okay, anyways.
We could be close to the Hellbender spot, or we could be very far.
We have no idea. We're relying on the kindness of monsters.
Monsters.
Well, not monsters. Pennsylvania natives.
We're dying.
Yeah, we're not doing too well, folks. It's nearing on 27 hours of driving, which I was already up for like 5 hours, so I'm on like 32 hours awake.
Except for like 3 days prior.
Yeah, Gage hasn't slept in multiple days. Not the trip's fault, but his genetics are just horrible and his body is broken. So we're doing real great, and we're hoping to find Hellbenders without just like keeling over and dying and being able to fully articulate an episode while operating at 0.03% mental capacity.
Quick, what's the Hellbender binomial?
Cryptobranchus alleganiensis.
Alligator Mississippi.
I'm an alligator.
To get to the lovely state of Pennsylvania, and as you, I'm sure you can see, we're in a beautiful crystal stream, and we are on the hunt for the largest salamander in North America. Today we are looking for the Hellbender, or Cryptobranchus alleganiensis. Now, these animals are super sensitive because they do a lot of their respiration through their baggy, slimy skin. So they require excellent, pristine habitat in order to survive and to thrive. So we're hoping that just walking through some of these beautiful, crystal clear waters, we can see one of the largest and most unique species of salamander that you can encounter here. Sorry, we are very tired. That you can encounter here in the eastern United States. So let's see if we can find the mysterious, the elusive Hellbender. We started off by scanning the riverbed looking for movement. Now, this is actually incredibly difficult because, as you might suspect, these animals have adapted to these environments for thousands and thousands of years. So they are quite well camouflaged in these slimy, flat, rocky creek systems.
My panties got wet.
My everything is wet.
Now, the first Hellbender we actually got to see was actually from the day prior, right after our 26, 27 hour drive. Now, this was right at dusk, so starting to get a little darker, and that's a lot of the time when these salamanders become active. They emerge often at dusk, perhaps at dawn as well, to hunt for crayfish primarily. So they come out from underneath large flat rocks that they've been hanging out under during the day, and they go about searching for food. Now, what's really cool about these awesome salamanders is they go through cutaneous respiration, which means most of their breathing is actually done through their skin. So they require fast-moving cold water that has a ton of dissolved oxygen in order to breathe properly. Now, these animals, like I said, require crystal clear water full of dissolved oxygen in order to properly respire, breathe, pull that oxygen into their bodies. So sadly, these animals are on the way out in a lot of their historic range due to pollution, due to too much sediment getting kicked up and pulled into the water through things like mining and all sorts of stuff like that. So it's critical that they have some of these strongholds, some of these natural wild spaces where the water runs clear. There's no examples of chemicals or fertilizers or anything like that in this water to affect those sensitive and amazing salamanders. Now, being North America's largest salamander is no easy feat. These animals can regularly reach lengths of over 22 inches. Take a look at this one. This is actually the largest individual we had the opportunity to film, and this animal was easily over 20 inches. That is gigantic. Now, they use this massive size to help them maneuver through their fast-moving aquatic environments. So they're able to use a powerful tail and strong arms to crawl through even the fastest moving streams to find areas to hide, to find mates to breed with, and of course, to find juicy prey to devour. But take a look at how this creature maneuvers through its beautifully pristine environment. What a cool looking animal. Now, these animals are protected, which is amazing because we need to get them all the protection they need. So this is going to be a hands-off video. We are simply out here trying to enjoy them as they move about their natural environment. We do not encourage people to go out and try and handle these animals because, once again, they are protected. We don't want to harm them in any way or stress them out in any type of way or do anything illegal to get us in trouble. So we're just out here trying to see them out on the move, perhaps looking for a new place to hunt for prey. This is a really good area. There's some intermittent shade. There's some cloud cover. It's later in the afternoon, so we should hit a window of activity, and hopefully we can see one or maybe more out on the move looking for things to eat and maybe looking for new rocks to shuffle under. Now, these animals are carnivorous, so what they're doing is they're using that flat, streamlined, sticky, slimy body to kind of suck to the riverbed, and they're poking in and under all sorts of rocks and things like that, and they're looking for fish, maybe tadpoles, and crayfish in particular, and they're just kind of probing around, and they use this big old wide Muppet mouth to grab onto prey, destroy it, and eat it at their leisure. Now, just because you're the biggest, baddest salamander on the block doesn't guarantee that your life won't have any hardship. So this was actually the third salamander that we were able to see. And take a look at that little white patch on its nose. Now, if I had to guess, I would say this might come as an injury from predating crayfish. Crayfish are equipped with powerful pincers, and they could easily inflict a blow on a hungry hellbender. So this little guy had a little scar on his nose, but as you can see, he's doing quite well, and that should heal up and fade in no time. Now, these animals are ridiculously impressive, and they have their own separate lineage here in America, and they've been here since the time of the dinosaurs. Now, these animals are actually the fourth largest salamander in the entire world, the first largest in the Americas, and they fall behind the Chinese giant salamanders, two species, and the Japanese giant salamander. So these are pretty heavy hitters. These are big, impressive, amazing salamanders, and we just love seeing them. Love it. This has been at the top of my list of animals to find for ever. Second I learned about these, I was like, I have to see that. It's like a little mini Coolosuchus or something. This huge, massive, wide-mouthed salamander right in my home country of the United States of America. So how cool are these amazing cryptic animals?
Now, although these animals are perfectly adapted at moving around their environment, they are not always super graceful. Look at this one we were watching swim or walk through its environment. It actually got caught on this little rock looking for a place to hide, and the current kind of flipped it over, so he might have been a little embarrassed. But I just could not get enough of these salamanders. They are just so beautifully unique, so amazingly adapted to their environments, and just such a cool species to finally have under my belt. The amazing, the beautiful Eastern Hellbender. Take a look at that cutie booty.
Now, I am super, super excited that we were able to find some of these amazing salamanders, and I am passionate about keeping these as part of America's wildlife. So I'm going to attach some links in the video description on how you can educate yourself on and better help the conservation of these amazing, gigantic salamanders. So be sure after the video is finished, you hop down to the description of the video and you click on some of those links to see what you can do to help keep America wild and help keep rivers open for these gigantic snot otters.
We actually ended up seeing three amazing Eastern Hellbenders, and I can't even describe what an amazing experience it was. I'm so happy to have finally seen these amazing animals in their natural habitat.
Well, we ended up finding multiple Hellbenders, which was ridiculously awesome, and we were able to capture some usable footage of them at least for this video. So this was an amazing experience. It was definitely worth the killer drive that we had to make to get here. So thank you guys so much for watching. Remember to like, comment, share, subscribe, turn on post notifications, join our channel memberships for exclusive behind the scenes content, buy our merchandise, and just overall support Jack's World of Wildlife so we can continue to bring you guys just amazing, amazing content like this today. I hope you guys learned a bunch about this really unique and awesome salamander that we have here in the Eastern United States, and I hope you guys had fun. So thank you so much for watching, and tune in next time for the next episode of Jack's World of Wildlife.
Yeah, oh my gosh. I can't even...
Hold on, I think I'm gonna throw up. I'll be fine. If I throw up, I'll throw up towards you.
You will not. Absolutely.
The JWAW viewers, you want to see me throw up on Jack's legs?
No, you won't.
It'll be great. Oh, wait, hold on. I'll just
turn that off.